In 1609, a group of pilgrims left England for religious freedom in Holland, where they lived and they prospered. But after a few years, their children were being influenced by Dutch culture. This worried the pilgrims. They considered the Dutch frivolous and their ideas a threat to their children's education and morality. This group of Bible believers decided to leave Holland and travel to the New World. On September 6th, 1620, the pilgrims set sail for the New World on a ship called the Mayflower. They sailed from Plymouth, England, and aboard were 44 pilgrims and 66 others who the pilgrims called strangers. The long trip was cold and damp and took 65 days. Many passengers became sick, and one person died by the time land was sighted on November 10th. After land was sighted, a meeting was held, and an agreement was worked out called the Mayflower Compact, which guaranteed equality and unified the two groups. They joined together and named themselves the Pilgrims. Although they had first sighted land off Cape Cod, they did not settle until they arrived at Plymouth. The Pilgrims' biggest concern was attacked by local Native American Indians, but the tribe that was there were a peaceful group and did not prove to be a threat whatsoever. The first winter was devastating to the Pilgrims. The cold, snow, and sleet was exceptionally heavy, interfering with the work as they tried to construct their settlement. Of the 110 pilgrims and crew who left England, less than 50 survived that first winter. On March 16th, 1621, what was to become an important event took place. An Indian brave walked into the Plymouth settlement. The pilgrims were frightened until the Indian called out, "Welcome," in English. His name was Samoset. Samoset left the next day. He soon returned with another Indian named Squanto. It was Squanto who taught the pilgrims how to tap maple trees for sap. He also taught them to plant crops. The harvest in October was very successful, and the pilgrims found themselves with enough food to put away for the winter. They had built homes in the wilderness. They had raised enough crops to keep them alive during the long coming winter. They were at peace with their Indian neighbors. They had beaten the odds, and it was time to celebrate. Governor William Bradford proclaimed a day of thanksgiving to be shared by all the colonists and the neighboring Native Americans. They invited Squanto and the other Indians to join them in their celebration, which lasted for 3 full days. The following year, the pilgrims' harvest was not as bountiful. They were still unaccustomed to growing corn. The third year brought a spring and summer that was hot and dry, with the crops dying in the field. Governor Bradford ordered a day of fasting and prayer, and it was soon thereafter that the rain came. To celebrate, November 29th of that year was proclaimed a day of thanksgiving. This day is believed to be the real true beginning of our present Thanksgiving Day celebration. The custom of an annually celebrated Thanksgiving held after the harvest continued through the years. During the American Revolution in the late 1770s, a day of national thanksgiving was suggested by the Continental Congress. In 1863, President Abraham Lincoln appointed a national day of thanksgiving. And since then, each president has issued a Thanksgiving Day proclamation, usually designating the fourth Thursday of each November as this holiday. We need to be thankful for what God has given to us as a nation, for our godly foundation, and for the Christian heritage that we have received from our founding fathers. On this Thanksgiving Day Sunday, we take time to celebrate Thanksgiving with our God and Savior, Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for blessing these United States of America.